Hello students, in this video we will study about the various theories related to the Darwin's theory of evolution. Darwin's theory of natural selection. The theory of natural selection was conceived by Darwin during a 5-year voyage from 1831 to 1836 on board the HMS Beagle, a vessel that had been commissioned to make oceanographic charts for British Admiralty. The Galapagos Island proved to be an important point of research for him. Here, it intensively studied the birds' population of finches. Natural selection is one of the strongest forces of evolution. Natural selection as guiding force was a principal contribution of Charles Darwin to the evolutionary biology given as early as 1859 in his book On the Origin of Species. However, Darwin did not fully comprehend how it operates, as mechanism of genetics was not known at that time. Natural selection favored those features of an organism that brought into a more efficient adaptive relationship with the environment. Natural selection molds the genotypes of organisms so that they produce phenotypes best fitted to their environments. In early 20th century, an English mathematician, Godfrey Hardy, and a German physician, Wilhelm Weinberg, explained the conditions required for gene frequency in a population to be the same. Hardy and Weinberg were of the view that gene pool frequencies are stable and do not change by themselves. The gene or allele frequencies will remain unaltered unless evolutionary mechanisms such as natural selection, mutation, cause them to change. Hardy and Weinberg postulated that gene frequencies in a population will remain stable if all matings are random, mutation is not occurring, natural selection is not occurring, the population is infinitely large, and there is no migration in or out of the population. Hardy and Weinberg developed a simple equation that can be used to find out the probable genotype frequencies in a population and to track generational changes in them. This came to be known as the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium equation, which is p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1. In this equation, p is defined as the frequency of the dominant allele and q as the frequency of the recessive allele of a trait controlled by a pair of alleles. However, it is highly unlikely that any of these conditions, let alone all of them, actually fulfilled in the actual world. Thus, evolution is inevitable. The natural processes that result in genes, changes in gene pool from one generation to the next, are mechanisms that cause evolution. Natural selection is one such mechanism or force that brings about evolutionary change by favoring differential reproduction of genes, which produces change in gene frequency from one generation to another. Darwin's theory of artificial selection. According to Darwin, the commonest method of producing new race of individual is that of selected under human control. The man selects only useful variety of plants and animals and breeds them together, expecting that offspring will have beneficial characters. Thus, various new races of plants and animals are produced which are more useful, viable, and of domestic value to common man. Darwin's conceived about this selection at two levels, at the conscious level and at the unconscious level. At the conscious level, which is also called the conscious selection, means that the man purposely takes two important characteristics, cross-breeds the species, and then a desired effect is seen in the offspring. At the unconscious level, it so happens that the species itself breeds together to form a better species in an unconscious selection. Darwin's theory of sexual selection. According to this theory, there is always a contest among males for the possession of beautiful females. During this contest, inferior males are eliminated due to their less courageous nature and ill-equipped with weapons of combat, and superior males dominate. Darwin put forth several examples to explain competition among males for possession of females, such as a stag with beautiful horns, a cock with heavy spur and strength in wings is more attractive to the female hen. Fighting among male alligators for possession of females, fighting among male salmons, etc. All these examples show that the males have been in a contest for the possession of a beautiful female. Darwin's theory of common descent. The theory supposes that related group of individuals have common ancestors, for example, man and apes. Similar to the theory of natural selection, it has been found correct. Men and apes bear several common characters that can be traced back to their ancestors in the evolutionary sequence. Darwin's theory of phanogenesis. As laws of inheritance were not known in the times of Darwin, he proposed theory of phanogenesis to explain the same. The theory is absolute, incorrect, and hence abandoned, and has only historical significance. According to this theory, all somatic cells of organisms produce minute particles called phanogenes, which are included in the germ cells. Moving forward from the theories of Charles Darwin's, we now come to the criticism of Darwinism. Darwinism has been criticized by physical scientists and neo-Darwinian biologists. Physical scientists were strongly inclined to atomistic reductionism and considered experimentation to be true scientific method. They had great prestige and authority. Darwinism suffered a great deal at their hands because of their demands, and evolutionary biology should be a science like physical science, which with its set of absolute laws and abilities to supply proofs. Non-Darwinian biologists. There are two classes of such biologists. A radical minority denied that natural selection played a role in evolution, while the majority did not deny the existence of selection but denied, as had Darwin himself, that selection alone could not account for all adaptations and evolutionary changes. With this, we complete the topic of Darwinism and the various theories related to theories of evolution by Darwin. We now will do some multiple choice questions based on this topic. So the first question is, the theory of natural selection was conceived by. Your options are E.B. Taylor, Charles Darwin, Jean-Baptiste Lamarck or Robert Redfield? The correct answer to this question is B. Charles Darwin. The book On the Origin of Species was written by, your options are A. Charles Darwin, B. Herbert Spencer, C. Edmund Leach, D. Alfred Russel. So the correct answer for this question is Charles Darwin. Question 3. According to Hardy-Weinberg law, which of the following is not a condition for the gene frequencies to remain stable? The first option is A. No mating, B. No migration, C. No mutation, and D. No selection. The correct answer for this question is A. No mating. The Hardy-Weinberg law states that random mating is essential for gene frequencies to remain stable in a population. The fourth and the last question. Which of the following is the correct equation for Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium? Option A, P square plus 2PQ plus Q square is equal to 0. The second option B is P square plus 2PQ plus Q square is equal to 1. Option C, P square plus 2P square Q plus Q square is equal to 0. And the fourth option D is P square plus PQ plus Q square is equal to 0. The correct option among these equations is B, P square plus 2PQ plus Q square is equal to 1. Here, P is the dominant allele and Q is the recessive allele of a trait in the population. With this, we have learnt about the various theories of evolution propounded by Charles Darwin. We have studied the theory of natural selection, Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, Darwin's theory of artificial selection, Darwin's theory of sexual selection, theory of common descent, theory of panagenesis, and we also studied the criticism of Darwinism by physical scientists and evolutionary neo-Darwin biologists.